over.
Welcome to Le Castellet in France. It's round two of the 2023 European Le Mans Series. And from here on in, there is a race every month up to the grand finale in Portimão, Portugal, a double race weekend. The winners of the season's opening race, Racing Team Turkey, still at the airport, a good time to catch up with them.
Hi, I'm Charlie Eastwood. I'm 27 years old from Belfast, Northern Ireland. I'm driving the 34 Racing Team Turkey car in the ELMS series. I think Barcelona really just was like a monkey off the back a little bit, because we felt like we were so close to that overall podium for the last couple of years, and just one thing after another, we were just finishing fourth or fifth or something like this. But yeah, everything came together in Barcelona, and it's now just give us even more confidence for the rest of the year.
I'm Sanadi Huluc, I'm 37. I'm a driver for Racing Team Turkey, number 34, LMP2 car. I've been racing with TF Sport for the last 7-8 years, and I've always had in the back of my mind, to start it as a Turkish team and to race under Turkish flag. There was a lot of demand from my country to do so as well. It's the first time a Turkish team is on one of the biggest stages on endurance racing, and also was in Le Mans. And yeah, I feel happy and proud about it. ELMS became one of the most, if not the most important LMP2 championship in the world now. So yeah, I'm happy to be a part of it.
I'm Louis de Letras, 26 years old, driving the 34 for Racing Team Turkey. I joined Racing Team Turkey obviously because we want to win. They were definitely the best outfit to do this year, I think, teaming up with Charlie and Sally to be on a such top level car and crew is fantastic. Obviously the difference between LMP2 and LMP2 Prime is the regulation. We have Sally, who is a bronze, but Sally is very fantastic this year, keeps improving every time he gets in the car. And obviously he proved in Barcelona he was on pace. So it's great because it gives us the chance to fight for overall wins, and there's an overall championship and we'll be aiming for that.
Welcome to Le Castellet, where Circuit Paul Ricard is hosting European Le Mans Series for the second round of the season. Now, it's been a good few months since the opening round in Barcelona, where number 34 Racing Team Turkey took a superb victory. But they're not the only ones going for gold this weekend. Team Edex Sport have the home advantage, as they are a French team. Now, let's catch up with one of their drivers, Paul-Louis Chaton.
As a French driver, Le Castellet, it's our home race, and yeah, it's National Day, so it's always something special for us. We are proud to be French, we are proud to be part of a French team with French color. So of course we want to do well, and we want to show that at Edex Sport we are here to fight for the top. If we win, maybe we'll do something special. Our goal is to win this weekend. We know everybody are here to win, but I think that since the beginning of the season, we show some good performance, we had good pace, we did hyper pole at Le Mans. That means that we are really in fight to try to get a good result. And for the team, as for the driver, we will be really happy to win, especially with the National Day. Every time before a race, or I try to do simulators to have all my automatics in my mind, or I watch a lot of onboard to just arrive, and as soon as I exit the pit, I exactly know what I have to do, because we know that we have few laps before qualifying and before the race because a lot of traffic, some red flags, and we have three drivers to share the car. So all the things that you can prepare ahead of the free practice, it's win time on track. I won in 14 with Signatec Alpine. It was my first year in the LMS, and it was a really nice moment. But you know, sometimes when you arrive and you win, it looks too easy. You know, oh, I win, it's normal. And after, when you have some difficult years the year after, when you come back and you win again, you appreciate it even more because you know how many sacrifices and how hard it is to win. You know, I was with Ben Hanley all my stint, and I was as fast as him everywhere or faster at some places, but at T11 he catch at least three times to me there, all the laps. I have too many fun facts because I'm in the team with Idex Sports since 2017, so like 7 years in a row with them, so we share a lot of moments, and of course with Nicolas Minachon, with Paul Lafargue, they are really part of my family. So when I arrived with Idex Sports, I arrived for my job as a racing driver, but it's also like if I arrive with my family. I think it's a learning process, and I know what's really important, and if we want to win, we have to win together.
Let's focus up a little bit on the LMGTEs. Now, it was the number 44 Aston Martin Vantage of GMB Motorsport that was fastest in free practice two. Now we've got the opportunity to talk to one of their drivers, Nicky Thiem, and ask him some very special questions. It's box, box, box time.
European Le Mans Series, welcome to the box, box, box. Who are you? My name is Nicky Thiem from Denmark, obviously. Driving for Aston Martin Racing, GMB Motorsport, so all Danish. Let's continue here, how old I am. I'm 34 years old. Instagram post. Oh, it's actually, yeah, right here, right now, from Paul Ricard. From yesterday, we had our beautiful, long test day, so long, good day signed off, so obviously that had to go on Instagram. Oh, God. Yeah. There's a little bit different opinions, but I would say it's a beautiful 10. Oh, I'm a big fan of Will Ferrell. Who isn't? But Will Ferrell, what a brilliant guy, what a brilliant man. So, yeah. Can you describe us your worst quality? Doesn't seem like, but too emotional at work sometimes. So, yeah. Always out in the back screaming or something just to calm yourself down, but I seem like a calm guy, but behind the scenes it's a different story, but yeah, I guess it's good. It shows the love to what I'm doing. My best quality, I'll say just a heavy right foot, go hard or go home since day one. So yeah, basically it, I guess that's what it's all about around here, is just to have a heavy right foot. And for the session, just some good old rock and roll music. So we always love that, some Guns N' Roses, whatever I could come up with. Rolling Stones, actually got the Rolling Stones socks on right now, so it's yeah, good old rock and roll music. What is daily drive? Yeah, I'm a family man now, so I just have a pretty boring Volkswagen Tiguan, so I'm not so into that stuff. It just had to be practical, just bring me from A to B, and no need to show off. Basically, Aston Martin style is undercover, and then we do all the business out here. And your dream car? Aston Martin Valkyrie. Good for family car. Perfect family car. True or false? And then you are going to win a race. True. Always stay positive. Still a long way to go here in the ELMS season. So yeah, true. Always cheering on my team, my teammates. So I believe we can do it. And yeah, good luck. Thank you so much, fans. Thank you so much for watching this. And stay tuned and enjoy the show and support the whole paddock and all the drivers and all the teams. Thank you, guys.
The race weekend is well underway, and we are with number 31, Racing Spirit of Le Mans. They are currently third in the LMP3 standings, and they're going to show us that motorsport is all about team spirit.
1 minute, under 1 minute to open pit exit for LMP3 qualifying session.
15 minutes in which to be the fastest of them all. Qualifying really puts extreme pressure on the drivers.
3, 2, 1. Pit exit is now open for LMP3 qualifying.
Okay, Antoine, info from GT3 quali. Huge headwind at senior, so getting a slipstream into senior will really help you. Copy. I'd rather be on my own though.
53.2.
Not that fast. Oh, he's going to have to change the tyres. He's about to, I think. Yeah, if he feels something or maybe not. Not much time. 8 minutes. That's okay. Sector 1, losing 4 tenths. 4 tenths in Sector 1, Antoine. Really, Sector 1, we have to push. Not good. Not good. 2 laps left. It's all about ups and downs. After a spin, then going up to P6. The team finished qualifying in 11th. Team spirits about staying positive when things aren't going your way. We're going to have to do some overtaking tomorrow.
Too quiet.
Yeah, I think so. It's going to be key to get some places. So let's find out how well they did go on race day. Sunday morning, 10 a.m. It's already 30 degrees, but it's race day. A show from a trials bike, autograph session, and thousands of fans in the pit lane meeting their drivers as the whole European Le Mans Series family prepares for the 4 hours of Le Castellet. The final moments of peace before battle begins. Paul in GTE went to the 77 Proton Competition Porsche, 29th overall, ahead of Spirita Race and the second Proton car in third. 6 rows ahead of them, the fastest LMP3 car, Rinaldi Racing's number 12 machine, 17th place overall, with Euro International and Nielsen hot on their heels. Racing Team Turkey have the Pro-Am pole. They will start in 7th place overall. Proton Competition and Nielsen, their closest rivals. But Cool Racing again have pole position, as they did in Barcelona, ahead of Edex Sport and Panis.
Thank you.
are ready to go racing in Le Castellet. Vladislav Lomko with the grey Cool Racing car, Paul Lafargue alongside the pole sitter for Edex Sport. Lomko dropping a long way back. Look, Paul Lafargue and the Inter-Europol car are a long way clear. They can't cross the start-finish line before the pole sitter. Lomko with a phenomenal run. Well, that really caught the right-hand column of cars by surprise. Vladislav Lomko leads. Manuel Maldonado moved up into second place for Panis Racing. He was third on the grid. So the cars on the left-hand side of the grid had a big advantage. Trouble for Dragon Speed. Henrik Hedman facing the wrong way in turn one. It's almost always contact in the big field here at Le Castellet in those first corners. Everything really bottlenecks up here, and then they sweep out onto the long Mistral straight in the background. Manuel Maldonado with Paul Lafargue right beside him. Lafargue trying to find a way back through, and then the blue and black car of Algar Pro, that's Kiffin Simpson. He's part of the action here. Down the inside comes Lafargue, and Edex Sport up into second place at the end of the opening lap. But will they hold on with the red highlights? The Panis car of Manuel Maldonado and Kiffin Simpson trying to get a run down the outside. They're nearly three wide into turn one. Simpson hanging out around the outside, and he moves up into third place. Nicola Pino next up for the Duquesne Engineering team. That's the green highlights. We ride on board. This tight opening sequence, very different from the Mistral straight that follows it, but so critical for getting your positioning right to move up in the slipstream. Torsten Kratz leading in LMP3 for WTM by Rinaldi. They had mixed fortunes at the Road to Le Mans, but have had a good season so far, always competitive. Torsten Kratz leading by nearly 5 seconds from Nielsen Racing. Battle continues. Kiffin Simpson and Paul Lafargue. This is for second place. Down the Mistral and up to the fearsome flat out senior, where all of your aerodynamics is so important. That's a big move. Simpson on the inside, up to second. Panis car is right there. Manuel Maldonado hunting around. So too the Duquesne car and into Europol. In LMP2 Pro-Am, Sally Jolich in second place, got jumped by the 99 Proton car at the start. Leader Giorgio Roda with so much experience in GT Porsches.
Good job, Giorgio. Good job. You just concentrate on driving yourself. You're doing a really good job.
Replay here of the yellow Ferrari of JMW Motorsport. Martin Berry spinning out at the final corner in traffic. Here's the lead battle. Christian Reed. Proton competition, 77 car right behind him. Irish actor Michael Fassbender in the Sister 93 machine. Christian Reed with all the experience, but Fassbender getting quicker and quicker with every race over his voyage through GT3. Right now, following in the boss's wheel tracks. Here's the queue for third behind 55 of Duncan Cameron. The Kessel car, the yellow car, Takeshi Kimura and Jens Moller for GMB Motorsport in the Aston. Side to side, wheel to wheel. GMB just ahead by a nose at the line, but Kimura with the inside line. Jens Moller not going to be able to hang on there. Oh, looks like the door mirror is coming off the Ferrari. So there was contact between them somewhere. Proton 1-2, Spirit of Race in third, then the TF Sport Aston in fourth position ahead of Formula Racing, and then Takeshi Kimura in the Kessel Racing car in sixth ahead of Jens Müller and Ryan Hardwick in the 16 Porsche. Here's the battle for third in LMP3. Number seven car in front is Tony Wells for Nielsen Racing. Two Euro International cars, Adam Alley and Glenn Van Berlo, queuing up to go by in the slipstream. And that's the big effect of the slipstream on the Mistral. They just left Tony Wells dead in the water, and through goes Glenn Van Berlo. So he made up two spots there. Race leader still Vladislav Lomko, the pole, sitter for Cool Racing. Algar Pro in second place. There is Kiffin Simpson. A little bit of traffic between them. Panis Racing in third with Manuel Maldonado. The gap out just over 4.5 seconds. Here is the battle for third place in GTE. The 55 Spirits race car still third. And our LMP2 Pro-Am second place car. That's Rodrigo Sales with the red highlights on the blue prototype. A little bit of smoke off the back of the car. A little bit of a lock up there. Looks like they're all still making it through without too much problem. On board with Johnny Lawson in the Formula Racing car. In fifth place in GTE. There is lots of smoke there from Rodrigo Sales. And that is a left rear puncture, surely. Smoke pouring off the car. Team ready in the pits for Rodrigo Sales, and in he comes. Well, the tyre's not flat. Maybe the bodywork had been knocked down onto it, but it has made a mess of the tyre anyway. Change of rear end. Go, go, go. Oh, looping spin from Michael Jensen in the Team Virage number 8 machine. Wow. Vladislav Lomko, the race leader in the pits for Cool Racing. They are right at pit in. Absolutely critical, the work of the team to make sure that they gain as much time as possible. Algarve Pro are in as well. That's Kiffin Simpson. Nicolas Pino in for Duquesne. And IDEX Sports, Paul Lafargue is in as well. Battle for third place between the two Ferraris in GTE. Duncan Cameron on the outside. Takeshi Kimura bumps his way through. That was a little bit ungentlemanly. Battle for sixth place in GT3. Ryan Hardwick in the 16 Porsche right behind. Johnny Larsen and Jens Moller, two Danes, hard at it. The Formula Racing car going the long way round the outside. And through he goes, passes the Aston Martin. The slipstream really working superbly here without headwind on the Mistral Strait. Battle for third in LMP3 coming up to senior. Look for the yellow and green. That is into Europol's Rui Andrade, Le Mans winner. Nicola Pino right behind him for Duquesne. And they're all over the back of the ultimate car. And that slowed up the into Europol car. And through goes Pino. The ultimate number 35 machine, a lap down, and that really held up Rui Andrade in traffic, and Nicola Pino going straight by. Take a look again, watch the red car, just squeezes up to the apex. There is contact there, but looks like no damage as Duquesne goes by. Johnny Larsen, Jens Moller still hard at it in this battle for seventh place in GT3. And again, the Aston Martin can't quite get on terms with the Ferrari into the braking area. All trouble behind Algar Pro. And that is the 20 car Fred Pordad looping around in traffic. Frantic racing in really hot conditions. There, of course, is Francois Perodo and Giorgio Roda, the blue and black of Proton behind the zebra car of AF Corsa. This is for fourth place in Pro-Am. The Proton car just getting a little bit wayward there. Multi-class racing is always very busy. The green and white Ferrari passing the yellow Porsche that's a lap behind it, and then two LMP2s coming alongside. Henrik Hedman in the white car, Paul Lafargue in the blue one, on board with Lafargue for IDEX Sport. See how the gap closes. That's very close indeed. A little too close for comfort. Our GT Danes are still at it. Jens Moller in the Aston Martin for GMB, attacking Johnny Larson's Formula Racing Ferrari once more. Still can't find a way through. Just ahead of them, Duncan Cameron now in fourth place in GTE. Take a look here, replay at senior. Arnaud Robin in the Aston Martin attacking Michael Fassbender. This is for the lead in GTE. Fassbender just a little wide out of senior. Arnaud Robin gets his nose down the inside in the Aston, and The Irish driver has to just back out of it a fraction and leave themselves some room for racing. Change for the lead. Torsten Kratz, LMP3 leader in the pits at WTM by Rinaldi. New nose going on to the Interpol car of Rui Andrade. That's after that contact with the back marker that cost him a position at the Double Droit de Bosse. Alex Lynn in the Algarve Pro Garage, part of the star-studded lineup here. Tiemann van der Helm waiting at Panis. And Vladislav Lomko brings the cool racing car in from the lead to hand over to Rashad De Gerus. Kevin Simpson, hot work as he's handed over to Alex Lynn at Algarve Pro. And Nicolas Pino debriefing with the Algarve Pro engineers. Seventh place battle in GTE. And contact, Takeshi Kimura getting turned around by Jens Muller's Aston Martin. Muller's spinning as well. You can see he was trying to get himself out of the hole he dug, but there may be a penalty to come. Let's get down to Algarve Pro, where Steph Wentworth is with Kiffin Simpson.
Yeah, it was a really good stint. The car felt amazing the whole stint, and we were able to get up to P2 pretty quick. And after that, I was just trying to chip away at the lead. Traffic wasn't helping us sometimes and helping us others, so it was hard to get close enough to make a move, but we were able to save enough fuel and now we're out in the lead.
Battle for fourth place in GTE, Michael Fassbender with a silver nose, right behind him teammate Ryan Hardwick, and behind them is the Duquesne number 30 LMP2 car. He'll find a way past easier than Hardwick does, that's for sure. On board, looking back from Fassbender, Hardwick with a big lock-up. That was clumsy. Takes them both off the road. Fassbender, the innocent party there, thoroughly thumped. There may be a penalty coming the way of the number 16 Porsche as well for that contact. We'll take a look again on board from Fassbender. Down the inside comes Ryan Hardwick, but too late. Into too tight a turn. Fassbender can't believe it. Problems for Tony Wells at Nielsen. Right front wheel is missing. That is not the race leader, Alex Lynn. That is Tony Wells coming back in with a right front wheel that's gone astray. And that was coming on to the Mistral. Ferrari of Johnny Larson. Looks like a little bit of damage on the right front corner of that car. He's in fifth ahead of Proton's Michael Fassbender. A couple of LMP2 cars between them. And here's how the positions changed. Down the inside into the Double Droit de Bosse. A Ferrari sneaking through under braking. That was a good move. So that's not where he picked up the damage. On board again with Fassbender. Into the long, never-ending right-hander, the Ferrari straight by. Back with that battle, and Fassbender has fought back in front of Johnny Larson. Porsche versus Ferrari, it's a story as old as racing itself, almost. Certainly in GT. Poor LMP2 car trying to find a way through. At low speed, really struggling against the grip of these GTEs, and Larson on the inside, contact, Fassbender turned around for a second time, just gone past the pits, there's debris in the straight. Yellow flags are out, safety car is out as well. And could everybody just stop hitting Michael Fassbender's Porsche, please? Well, at least this time, I suppose, it wasn't his own teammate, but Johnny Larson just taking a little bit of a liberty on the exit of the final turn. And there is debris that needs clearing up there as well. Quite a lot of it. Again, on board with Fassbender, and again, getting hit from behind. Back to green flag racing, nearly halfway through the 4 hours of Le Castellet. Alex Lynn leads from Rashad De Gerus, Tiemann van der Helm, Rennie Binder, Marina Sato, and Lawrence Hoare. That is the top half dozen. The Algarve Pro car streaking away. Here comes the battle for third, Panis versus Duquesne. On board with Rennie Binder in the number 30 Duquesne car. Gonna send it down the inside. No, not quite close enough. but really challenging Panis's team in Vanderhelm. Vanderhelm in the blue and red highlights, number 65 car. And behind them, Marino Sato, the Japanese driver for United Autosports in their 22 car, and Lawrence Hoare for IDEX Sport ahead of Inter Europol. So a busy race so far on board with Racing Team Turkey. They're leading in Pro-Am. Oh, trouble. And that is Arnaud Robin in the TF Sport Aston. And he's in the barriers. Into the pit lane comes the Cool Racing number 17 machine. So Adrian Keeler handing over. Charlie Eastwood in the red and black Racing Team Turkey car under pressure from Rasad Dejeras in the grey Cool Racing car. He's right in the toe up the Mistral. Charlie behind two LMP3 cars. He's going to get boxed in a little. Dejeras goes very wide indeed. Can he make it through without a spin? Yes, he does. And that was for eighth place, or possibly fourth, with the pit stops underway. Eastwood diving around Rashad Dejeras. That was the pass just before they got onto the Mistral. Dejeras trying to keep his nose in front in the Cool Racing entry. Charlie Eastwood right behind him. An opportunity perhaps to pass next time down the Mistral. He's got to be close. On board Racing Team Turkey down to turn one. Cars in and out of the pits, left, right and centre. That makes traffic even harder to judge. Some cars might be going slower than you expect as they come out of the pit lane. Oh, an opportunity here for the Irish driver. Can't go around the outside there, but he is all over the back of the Cool Racing car as they come towards the start of the Mistral straight. So now the shoe will be on the other foot, and Charlie Eastwood needs to be in the slipstream right behind Rashad Dejeras. Here we go. Sweeping left, then right onto the Mistral. Race leader is in the pit lane, Alex Lynn. With Racing Team Turkey. Here we go. Rashad Dejeras sneaking down the inside of the GTE cars. Charlie Eastwood on the outside. Dejeras keeps his nose in front. This is fantastic stuff from this pair. Fantastic scrapping through the traffic. And Eastwood absolutely determined not to give this one up. Again, he's going to have to look around the outside. It's a tight right-hander that follows. Has he got through? Yes, he has. David Perel handing over to Duncan Cameron at Spirita Race, GTE Ferrari. Battle for the lead in LMP3. Leonard Weiss chasing down Euro International's Matthias Leuten with the yellow highlights. That's the Euro International car. There is Weiss, WTM by Rinaldi Racing, right with him. Has slashed the gap from 5 seconds to 0.25 of a second in four laps. Replay here of Duncan Cameron under attack for second in GTE from JMW's Lorcan Hannafin, and Lorcan goes by. Len Weiss was leading in LMP3, but Matthias Leuten of Euro International ahead of him. So what happened? Oh, a spin. Len Weiss, a rare mistake. Here's the battle for second overall. Down the inside of René Binder comes Lawrence Hoare. Oh, big, big twitch from the IDEX Sport car. But he gets his nose in front of the Duquesne driver. We ride on board with René Binder. And that looks like he's just made it stick. But Binder will be perfectly placed to fight back on the Mistral in the slipstream of the IDEX Sport car. Here we go, down the long, long Mistral straight into a headwind. And with Senior looming up in front of them, full course yellow, no chance to pass now. And that's because of debris on the track. The marshals will need a chance to pick that up.
3, 2, 1, full course yellow removed, full course yellow removed.
Now they're back at it. You saw Lawrence Hoare in the blue and black IDEX Sport car weaving a little, but as they went green, René Binder was straight on it, right by for Duquesne. back up to second. That's how you restart from the full course yellow. And they're on the Mistral, but I'm not sure that Laurence Hoare has got enough there to come by. Here's a battle, Frederik Schandor for Kessel Racing and Ben Tuck in the TF Sport Aston. The yellow Ferrari's been in the wars. This is for fourth place in GTE. Take a look here, down the inside comes Schandorf, the Dane, trying to grab the spot, and Ben Tuck just running a little wide in a double droit de Beausset. And you didn't think the battle for second was over, did you? Well, for sure, Laurence Hoare did not. Here he is attacking René Binder again for second place. Watch from the outside, sells the dummy, goes out wide. Binder defends on the inside, and Laurence Hoare straight down the inside. Battle for second in GTE, it's yellow Ferrari on yellow Ferrari, and the car guy car is Frederik Schandor for Kessel Racing, and he goes around the outside of Lorcan Hannafin's JMW Motorsport Ferrari. That was a good pass up to second place, but he's got his rival in the tow on the Mistral, and the Aston Martin of Ben Tuck not far behind. Schandorf needs to pick up a tow off the LMP2 cars if he can. He should stay in front there. Second place is his. Lorcan Hannafin will have to worry about the approaching Aston Martin and Porsche. Replay here of the change for the lead in LMP3. Racing Spirit Le Mans, Antoine Ducat dive bombing Leonard Weiss in the WTM by Rinaldi car. James Allen getting ready to head out for the Algarve Pro Team. Lorcan Hannafin under pressure from Ben Tuck. The Aston coming close, got a run around the outside. The yellow Iron Lynx Porsche is right behind them as well. Ben Tuck tucks in neatly in front of Lorcan Hannafin up to third at senior. Kessel Racing in second, Proton Porsche still leading here at Le Castellet. Algarve Pro in the pits, Alex Lynn is out, James Allen climbs aboard the leading number 25 car. Battle here as Martin Rump in the 93 Proton car dives by Maxime Robin in the TF Sport Aston. A little bit more debris added to the pile. That 93 car has certainly been in the wars. Robin with a better exit out of the final corner though, gets his nose back in front. So this is the battle for eighth place. TF Sport Aston ahead of Proton Porsche. Martin Rump is going to have to try again to get by that Aston. Porsche still looking strong here. There's Claudio Schiavone, one of the drivers of the 60 Iron Lynx Porsche. And that car all over the back of Ben Tuck in the TF Sport Aston Martin. Matteo Cressoni, you can't even see the yellow Porsche. It just looks like highlights on the Aston Martin. He is so close behind in the slipstream. Fantastic racing. Driver change at Iron Lynx, Matteo Cairoli taking over from Matteo Cressoni. LMP3 pole sitter Oscar Tugno getting in at WTM to start his stint. Alessio Picariello in the 16 Porsche going around the outside of John Lancaster in the JMW yellow Ferrari. Then the yellow and white car, Gregory Huffaker for Kessel Racing trying to get in on the action. This is 6th, 7th and 8th. Iron Lynx, the yellow Porsche, in fifth place, just ahead of them after their recent pit stop. Ferrari by Ferrari, and Huffaker and Lancaster. Lancaster with the racing line, Huffaker on the inside. Can he get through? Oh, yes, he just does.
It was a great stint, actually two great stints. The car was so good to drive, so I was just pushing all the way through. The tires kept with me, so I had everything from the car that I needed to go quick and to overtake.
And you are currently running in second place, just behind the Duquesne team, who you were having battles with as well. But you are a French team. This is technically your home race. Do you think you've got the home advantage?
We've been testing here a bit. I mean, the team builder has his new workshop just around the corner here in Le Castellet, so certainly we have some momentum also from Le Mans pole position that all pushes us.
Here's the battle for third place, Cool Racing, Jose Maria Lopez. Yes, the works Toyota hypercar driver, and Louis Delatraz right behind him for Racing Team Turkey. He's got a good slingshot into senior. No question the bravery of Delatraz, and the cool racing driver had to give him some space there. And here is the battle for the lead that Laurence Hoare and Steph were talking about. Paul-Luc Chatin for Edex Sport, we ride with him, chasing down Neil Jani, Porsche factory hypercar driver. He's in the 30 Duquesne car. This European Le Mans Series field is absolutely studded with star names, and some you might not expect. On board with Racing Team Turkey, Louis Delatraz. Now, Cool Racing may be third behind Duquesne and Edex Sport in LMP2, but that's not including Pro-Am. LMP2 Pro-Am race leader, Racing Team Turkey, are in third place overall. And don't forget, the Racing Team Turkey car won outright in Barcelona. 47 minutes of racing remains. Anything could yet happen. Duquesne versus Edex Sport right now, inches apart. We ride on board once more with Edex Sport's Paul-Luc Chatin, chasing Neil Jani onto the long, fast Mistral straight. Jani just too far away, I think, this time round. Battle here for supremacy. Algar Pro's James Allen versus Jose Maria Lopez. Pachito in the cool racing car, the Argentine driver on the inside. Yeah, hanging on. James Allen attacking for third place for Algar Pro. Cool racing at home here in France. Algar Pro will be at home for rounds 5 and 6, both in Portimão in Portugal. Into the pit lane for the final time, Racing Team Turkey, Louis Delatraz, the Pro-Am leader, and looking for an overall podium. In as well, number 25, this is Algar Pro from the lead of the race. On the headset, Nick Manassian giving instructions to Paul-Luc Chatin at Edex Sport. Racing Team Turkey leading overall. Battle for third in GTE. Gregory Huffaker in the Kessel Racing yellow Ferrari, all over the back of Alessio Picariello, the Belgian driver in the Proton competition number 16 Porsche. In these extreme heat conditions, drivers, tyres and cars are all feeling the pace. Final stages of the race. Tiny margin between them. Can Huffaker move up onto the podium at the expense of Picariello? A great pass if he can make it. Late race pressure for both teams here. Standing on the podium is just that little bit better than fourth place, even if the points yield isn't that much greater. Kessel Racing's Gregory Huffaker pushing hard. Alessio Picariello trying to keep his nose clean and stay in third. Racing Team Turkey, the Barcelona winners, leading into the final 15 minutes. There's Algar Pro's James Allen. He is closing the gap. There's the team boss, Samantha Cox. Algar Pro, come on, baby. He's closing the gap on Louis Delatraz of Racing Team Turkey. Either way, right now, Algar Pro are poised to win in LMP2, if not overall. And Racing Team Turkey poised to win in LMP2 Pro-Am. In LMP3, it's Anton Ducroix leading for Racing Spirit of Le Mans from WTM by Rinaldi, with Kuhl in third ahead of RLR M Sport. And that move on the Rinaldi car an hour or so ago by Ducroix is paying at dividends. They still have the lead in LMP3. Little replay of the battle for third in GTE. Alessio Picariello in the turquoise and black Porsche. Lock up there, has to straight line the corner, take to the escape road. 10 minutes to go, Racing Team Turkey still lead from Algar Pro, but the gap is coming down. James Allen now just 1.7 seconds back. Trouble in GTE, replay here. Alessio Picariello getting caught behind the United Auto Sports car, and Gregory Huffaker jumping the curbs but clattering into the back of the Porsche, sending him into the barriers. Leaders in traffic, and Louis Delatraz under attack. James Allen goes inside into the final corner. Through he goes for the lead. Louis Delatraz just getting held up by the number 11 Euro International car, but Delatraz back at it again. Got a little bit of an overlap down to turn one, but James Allen coming back alongside him. Allen with the inside line, the racing line into the first couple of corners. Delatraz right with him, door handle to door handle, then gives him room to survive. And that's a wise move by Louis Delatraz. On board with the Swiss driver, side by side through the chicane. Down the Mistral they come. Louis Delatraz under pressure from Neil Jarny. This is for second place. Neil Jarny for Duquesne. Looks to go around the outside. There's the race leader, Algar Prost, James Allen. Neil Jarny up to second place. Racing Team Turkey down to third. Inside the final 4 minutes. It exports Paul-Luc Chatin, the dark blue car, tagged around the nose of Alessio Picariello's Porsche, and that's going to cost them sixth place. On board with Chatin, trying to go the long way round. Thought he had got clear of the Porsche, but he hadn't. Last lap of the race, battle for third place. Pro-Am leaders, Racing Team Turkey, Louis Delatraz and Jonathan Aberdeen from Inter-Europol, the winners of LMP2 at Le Mans. Aberdeen not part of that crew, but looking to get onto the podium here. Overall, Delatraz shuts the door dramatically at senior. "You're not coming by me there," he says. Has he got enough to hang on for the remainder of the lap? The double droit de Bosse, he keeps it neat and tidy. Aberdeen's not going to get close here, I don't think. It might be close, but not close enough. Leaders on the final lap. Battle for third place continues. Out of the final corner, James Allen for Algar Pro. Victory in Le Castellet. Duquesne's Neil Jarny just a couple of metres behind him in second. And Racing Team Turkey win Pro-Am with third overall ahead of Inter-Europol and Cool Competition. LMP3 goes to Racing Spirit Le Mans from WTM and Cool, with Proton and Iron Lynx a Porsche 1-2 ahead of the best Ferrari from Kessel Racing in GTE. Proton's number 77 Porsche started on the GTE pole and they were still in front 4 hours later.
Yeah, you know, the car was really mega to drive, so setup, they could do a great job on setup and the balance was so nice. And you know, after the start in Barcelona, I'm quite happy to win this race. And Gianmarco and my little Shushu did a great job, so I'm super happy.
Proton coming out on top in GTE. Iron Lynx's yellow Porsche in second. And Kessel Racing taking third in their Ferrari. Iron Lynx have a 3-point series lead, the top seven covered by 10 points. Victory in LMP3 to Racing Spirit of Le Mans as Antoine Ducan brings them across the line to the joy of Jacques Wolff and Jean-Ludovic Foubert.
Yeah, it was a very difficult end of the race. They've done a very good job to keep the car clean with a good position, and I was able to come from P6 to P1, so yeah, very happy.
Joining Racing Spirit Le Mans on the podium, WTM by Rinaldi in second and Cool Racing in third. And that means the crew of the number 17 Cool car now have a 1-point advantage over Racing Spirit of Le Mans. Tight at the top, you betcha. They may not have won overall here, but LMP2 Pro-Am victory goes to Racing Team Turkey's Sally Olic, Charlie Eastwood and Louis Delatraz.
To be fair, I think we were very fast today. All the team did a good job, my teammates as well, and then 10 laps to go to front left blue, so I had a punctured tire basically the whole time. We better to stay out, and yeah, I could still save the overall podium, but not ideal.
So perhaps it could have been a second overall victory. Racing Team Turkey do claim LMP2 Pro-Am ahead of Cool Racing's 37 team and the 83 from AF Corsa. And that means, of course, that they stay on top of the points with a 19-point advantage over Francois Perodo and his crew in 83 and Cool Racing's number 37 lineup. Delight for James Allen and Algar Pro.
It was a crazy one. The start was pretty tough from fifth, and everyone kind of got stacked up with some weird stuff going on the right side. But after that, I just put my head down, tried to move forward, and we were able to pass it over to Alex in P1. So I think the whole team did a great job today.
First win of the season for Algar Pro, with Duquesne finishing second and Racing Team Turkey third overall. All of which means that the Duquesne team lead the standings in LMP2 ahead of Algar Pro, with Panis in third.
Now you guys are all caught up on all the action that has happened here in Le Castellet. We've seen the highs and lows here at Paul Ricard for the second round of ELMS. Now it's on to the third round, which will be held in Aragon, Spain. On the 26th of August, join us for the first night race. See you then.
Test your soul, you will walk out pure and whole, stronger than